Ok, bienvenidos. Voy a entrar primero para que te
I think in 2011 we had the chance to go live in Peru, and it was supposed to just be a year, an adventure, and we ended up volunteering at an orphanage while we were there, and long story short, decided to try to adopt some of them.
Bienvenidos.
The plan was to adopt an older child, and then we felt like they might be lonely if it was just one, so we thought, well, we'll try to take a sibling set so they have each other. And then the opportunity was presented to take two sibling sets. And I distinctly remember David saying, go big or go home. And pretty soon you have four teenagers. And we both were really fortunate and had great families growing up. And there were kids there that they didn't have families, at least that they were part of. And so we felt like we could offer that to them.
We were married in 2005, and I think had an idea right away that we were going to have kids, we were going to have our own family. And it didn't happen right away, it didn't happen the way we expected it to. This was probably back in like December or
November.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I said, in June, we're going to have two more kids move into the house with us. Alfredo was like, oh, you're going to adopt two more kids? Stephanie was like, oh, I know, you're going to foster. It's a student exchange program. And then I remember Alfredo was like, looked at Karen.
You could kind of see it like dawn on him, like this, wait, what?
Mom?
When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case, I can offer you a warm embrace to make you feel my love. When evening shadows and stars.
Yeah, today is their actual due date. They were born 6 weeks early, essentially, just under 5 pounds each, and now they're just under 8 pounds each.
Yeah.
He was born first. And he was Michael was transverse, and so they did an extraction for him and turned him and pulled him out by his feet. And his leg, his femur was broken in the process. So he had a harness on for the first like month. You know, so that's, it wasn't anything what we planned, but most of life isn't, so here we are.
It was sad. It was like we cried. I mean, it was like they should be together. They've been together the whole time. They've been developing. They're smashed together inside of Karen. And now they're like not able to touch each other. And so when the first time we put them together, we like rolled the other cart over and stretched the wires out to try to like get them as close as we could. And then Karen had a pillow on her lap and they kind of like rolled into the center and were touching each other. It was really tearful and kind of emotional moment.
Yeah, and, so sweet.
Uh-huh. What do we got? Let's try this.
Yeah, I mean, even when they're crying, I feel it's kind of, if anyone saw me, they'd probably think I'm a terrible mother because they're screaming, but you're kind of, like, sometimes I'm laughing.
It's okay, but...
Their face is red and their little tongue is wagging and they're just shaking. And you know, as soon as, the second you put some food in them, they're going to just totally melt and be fine. The other day, I, like, put one down, grabbed my plate of cold scrambled eggs, ran into the bathroom because I had to pee, and I'm sitting on the toilet eating my eggs really quick, and then like go back out of the bathroom, pick up the baby. Just like, I feel like the soundtrack should be like some really fast, crazy song, you know, just like you're just kind of always buzzing.
But it'll all be over soon. Life is going to get better. Mm-hmm.
When evening shadows and the stars appear. Where are you going? Yeah, it's tiring to eat.
I love when they reach. I don't know if they're reaching for each other, but it seems like a...
I know you haven't made your mind up yet.
So Noah is a little more demanding. The second he wants something, he just starts screaming. He has one volume. And Micah's much more chill at this stage anyway. And he's pretty happy. You feed him and you plop him down. And I have this theory that because he had the broken leg when he was first born, now he's like, he can roll with anything. So a little bit of gas isn't a big deal.
He hasn't been eating. I think he's done.
Yeah, he seems done. We love it. It's great. Yeah. We love it. It's fun.
Yeah. It's really, really special watching them because when, you know, adoption is so complex and you don't know if they're going to take that offer, you know, if they want to be part of the family or not, and if they'll ever feel part of the family. And, you know, two of our kids have moved out and are sort of doing their own thing, and maybe that'll change someday. But Stephanie and Alfredo, I feel like, did take that offer of family, and they're like fully, I mean, they're just in, and they're, something about seeing them with babies is like making it clear to me that like these are your brothers, you know, your little brothers. So yeah. It's cool, it's beautiful.
It says welcome a la familia. You know what, Micah? Yeah. I mean, they are twins,
I mean. They look like Noah and Noah. Like face of Noah.
It's been interesting to watch Stephanie and Alfredo kind of go through the emotional transition of like realizing that we're all family. They think that we're going to treat the babies, the boys, differently. You know, we've kind of joked about that. Stephanie is like always giving us a hard time. Like, we're not going to make them do chores. You know, we're going to treat
them.
We're going to buy them a car. Yeah. Having the four kids that we adopted be a part of our family was like a really conscious decision to like, hey, let's give them the best we can.
And not just us, not just the two of us, but both of our extended families. I'm one of seven and David's one of three, and our families are all really close. And so we felt like we were bringing them into that network of all the brothers and sisters and grandparents and all that. And
it's been kind of interesting to like kind of have them finish like growing up, finish maturing in a way as teenagers and become young adults and start their own path. And then it was after that that we, Karen and I, decided, okay, let's try to start.
So then when we did get pregnant and I had that experience, it was like, it almost verified that I was sad about it before, because it was such a rich and like, I mean, just amazing, mysterious and crazy and
beautiful. Yeah.
Beautiful. Yeah. The way that what the body can do and the miracle of it all.
No, it's a song that I sang when I was pregnant with them.
When the rain is blowing in your face and the whole world is on your case.
I'd go hungry, I'd go black and blue. I'd go crawling down the avenue.
8 years ago, we sort of made this offer, like, do you want to be part of the Martin family? And now here they are, part of the Martin family, and the family is growing, and they're like welcoming the next wave. So they'll always have each other, and I think that's really, really cool.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully.
Yeah.
Yeah.